Okay, shaking hands means we start the fight.
Yes, starting the round. Nguyen plays Ruslan Ponomarev.
And we're concentrating on this game. Aldrin Chedi and Rubinstein.
Yes, no experiments. It was very solid, traditional line of Nimtso. C takes D in our normal move. Okay, he tries to play the other way. Knight f4, of course, is no novelty at all. Yes, there was played.
Could be transposed anytime on C takes D5. Yeah. It's not so big deal.
No, but see, now C takes D5, then C takes D5, and I think, okay, it's very symmetrical structure.
But
no.
Black can play to win.
Yes, Ruslan doesn't like it, because, okay, CD is known at very solid equal position. Ruslan Ponomarev has some more aggressive plans in this game, so at the same time...
Well, it's natural, something like an orthodox gambit, where white has an extra tempo, a3, which is not maybe such importance, and the knight instead of f3 is on f4.
Yes,
well, everything has drawbacks, pros and cons.
Yeah, that's true, and I think that's the character of play. Okay, he's planning, yeah, this is typical plan for this position, preparing e4, but right now, at the moment, he cannot play it because after d e f e, the pawn is hanging. Pawn on d4 is hanging. Okay, so prepare this. One of typical reactions is c5, but this is a problem that d5 is hanging currently. So...
Well, I think also to play knight c7, e4, take, and c5 is not so bad.
But then, okay, then there are a lot of lines to calculate, and actually in playing this way, then I would not like this last move, rook f8, e8, because...
f7 is a bit weaker.
Yes, f7 might be a problem after all. Okay, it looks like Ruslan Ponomarev did... played a bit inaccurately on a few previous moves. E3, E4 is coming. Okay, it's not something like the end of the game, but if white succeed organizing E3, oh yes. Pawn sacrifice or what?
I mean, okay, not exactly because...
Oh yes, but why not exactly? Why not exactly? Oh yes, then he has bishop E6, but then, yeah, I don't see.
I think it's a pawn sacrifice after all, isn't it?
Yes, it's a pawn sacrifice. Ruslan really did not like the idea of e3, e4 coming, so he sacrificed a pawn.
Well,
trying.
Okay, but can't say that he should be happy with it.
Yes. I think the most he can hope for is just, let's say, some compensation. Doesn't look like, oh yeah, probably he just calculated everything precisely, because now when knight goes somewhere, then, well, bishop c4 wins the tempo, but then rook e1 defends
wins
e3.
Wins the tempo, but doesn't win stuff.
Doesn't win the pawn back. Yeah, that's true. But anyway, I think that black would have some compensation. Okay, not so clear if it can be enough, but...
What is the knight doing on a6?
Yeah, that's the only problematic piece.
So queen b6, I think it's only move to play. Yeah.
Yeah.
For blitz, this would be the only move, even for a classical game.
Yeah, but black
queens must be kept on the board.
Counter attack.
Mating in one should be prevailed.
Yes, but.
Okay, tempo will be gained back by rook d8 or something.
Rook d8 is coming. Yes, looks like Ruslan Ponomarev assessed things correctly.
Well, he has compensation, but I feel that this compensation for keeping the balance, preserving the balance, if everything works well.
Yes.
Still, white has to prove the correctness of his idea. Pound down, and nothing is sure.
Yeah, e3, e4 is coming. E3, e4. Okay, e3, e4 still can be met with bishop g7 in this case. Okay, retreating his bishop.
So it's time to take at least the bishop advantage. It's always good to feel that if you lose the pawn, then at least you're going to have some bishop pair.
Yep. offering queen exchange, but okay.
I think that white slowly will prevail. I don't like it at all. I don't see where is the counterplay. Okay, yeah. Temporarily I understand that the black might have something, but what is for sure is that white is trying to play for a draw.
White or black?
No, black. Sorry.
Black, yeah, black. But
I said black.
Yeah. Not so easy to develop pieces somehow. Okay, knight b3 now. Knight is positioned very well now. I think that actually the compensation is quite adequate. Maybe only, most probably only for draw, not for more. But
okay, white should here play something. I mean, doesn't have any meaning.
Yeah, bishop g5, bishop f6 is a knight idea. But then I think rook endgame must be drawn. After all, okay, bishop g7. Then I did not like this bishop. This rook f2. I thought he had to play bishop
h6. Here, I like h6 very much. Where he gonna go? Brown? Yeah. Yes, he's some trouble now.
Yes. Ruslan, just used.
And g5.
Then and g5 and taking on b2. Okay,
well,
looks
maybe,
like
maybe bishop c1 only move.
Nguyen has played something wrong, clearly. Okay, bishop c1 looks like the only.
What to do? You want to give up the pawn so easily?
Yes, otherwise
he just lose a pawn because of the weakness in the back rank.
Yes, that's true. But now,
okay, he has the conversation, but how?
Rook d3 maybe. I like black position.
Rook d3, yeah.
If someone is better here, then it's
only, yeah, rook d3 is nice.
Then it's black. Then
actually,
it's black.
After rook d3, he has to play only rook f1, only move, then rook c2.
Then rook comes to c2, yes.
Yeah, maybe even black is better here.
Yes.
Maybe this as well, but what?
Okay,
he decides to give a pawn.
Yes, hoping to survive somehow. Yes.
Maybe he doesn't give a pawn.
Yeah, rook b3, d3 is very strong.
Rook d3
yeah,
is better,
looks
yeah.
Like all over for Nguyen. Okay, he does not have enough time to get rid of this terrible pin.
Now he can choose how to play. But I think this is nice, correct stuff.
Yeah, rook just goes. Okay, king e2, rook h1. Okay.
Come on, b5.
But he's just out of moves. Yes, he's just out of moves. Yes, to unpin. He has to play. No, just ran out of moves.
He decided to give some pawns.
She take h.
Okay, it's time to start collecting. But still, you have to find something to move. So finally, white
managed
one pawn
to get rid of this pin.
But
this
how to play? Ouch.
Well, man. There might be some counterplay. So probably, okay, in blitz, of course, it's very hard to demonstrate high-level technique, and okay, it's one of the strongest points in Ruslan Panomov. Strange stuff.
Yeah.
Yes, this check is very important. But how to move the pawns?
Oh, he
Oh my God! Or it's
okay,
not
bishop
d4.
Now this is easier, isn't it?
Yes. And rook a6 then. Maybe this way either, yes. Incredible rook blunder by Ruslan Ponomarev. Yeah, the things were going perfect.